Imagine that it is the late 1960s and it's your birthday, or possibly another occasion where someone would give you a present, and you get this. That's a very nice present. This is the Bell Howell Record All Kit. It says the complete cassette recorder kit for work and play. Has a leather case, and this machine was so well cared for they never even took the foam out of the leather case. On the back of the machine, where they have the little embossment for the badge, it says model 87500. But you can see how nice it is. It has a black speaker grill, a faux walnut grain door with a little handle, so you can open it up like that. And a silver plate here, and your piano control keys here. Let's take a quick tour of the machine. You have your record button here, stop, rewind, fast forward, which is non-locking, play and record. You have a meter here, which indicates the battery. That's, and it also says level on it, but it is unnecessary because this is automatic level control. And here is your volume control. On the front of the machine, we see our inputs and outputs. It's a remote, microphone, auxiliary, and earphone. On the side here, you can see we have an adapter. It says external power, and it's 7.5 volts. There's nothing on the back. There is nothing on the other side. And on the very back of the machine, we have the battery compartment, which you simply open up like that, and is a very typical Sanyo design for loading in the batteries. This is a Sanyo machine. So to record, I'm going to put the microphone in the off position, press down the record button, press the play button, and it doesn't matter what the volume is set to, so I'm setting it to 0. I turn on my microphone switch, testing 1, 2, 3, 4, testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing the Bell & Howell solid-state cassette tape recorder from the late 1960s. It has automatic level control. Now I'm going to move the microphone far away from me. The microphone is far away from my voice, but I'm still speaking. Let's hear how that sounds. End of test. Now let's rewind. Turn up the volume.
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing the Bell & Howell solid-state cassette tape recorder from the late 1960s. It has automatic level control. Now I'm going to move the microphone far away from me. The microphone is far away from my voice, but I'm still speaking. Let's hear how that sounds. End of test.
To remove the cassette, you open the little door. You can use the handle or grab it by the sides, and you lift the cassette out of the machine. Notice that the inside of the door has all of this silver plating on it. They went to a lot of trouble to make this look very attractive. Bell & Howell is actually a Sanyo machine rebranded under the name Bell & Howell. And the way you can tell a Sanyo machine from a Philips type machine is to look at this idler here. If it's a single idler and has no belt going to a secondary idler, that's definitely a Sanyo design. if you have problems with thumping during fast forward or rewind, the problem is always the tire on this idler. And that is true of Sanyo and Philips machines, because when the machine is in stop, this idler is pressing against the capstan, and the spring can be pretty tight, so over time it's going to develop a flat spot. If that happens, you're going to have to take the tire off and replace it. A plumber's O-ring of the same size will do a great job, as long as you clean it and get the lubrication that they put on those things off. If you have problems with tapes jamming, many times the friction clutch in this idler has failed, and sometimes you can adjust it so that you can put more pressure between this white part of the idler and the plate, which is what drives the actual spindle. So keep that in mind. Like many of the Sanyo machines, it has this very well-designed amplifier board. There's an AC bias coil. Here is an adjustment for it. This slot helps you align the record play switch. This machine also has two extra transistors located under here, so it has a little bit more power than many of the Sanyos that I've seen under different brands. And of course, here's your input and output jack. Here again, we have a direct giveaway as to this being a Sanyo machine. For one thing, the speaker is held inside a little rubber cup located here. That makes it very convenient for working. You'll also probably notice that the spring that pushes the cassette against the cassette stops here has a plastic guard on it. That's also characteristic. The most telling characteristic, however, is this construction here, where you have an idler and a secondary idler for the rewind. And that's necessary because they don't change the direction of the motor. So when it is in rewind, you can see that the drive idler is spinning against the intermediary idler, which then is turning against the feed table, causing it to turn in reverse. When it's in fast forward, there is no secondary idler needed. Now, this again is a very typical Sanyo machine because the fast forward is not locking. And of course, here it is in play. And in play, of course, they do disengage this mechanism from the capstan flywheel. This Bell & Howell has an electric erase head, electric record head, and all the characteristics you would expect from the very fine design that Sanyo put into this type of mechanism.
Thank you for watching this video all about me, the Bell & Howell 87500 solid state cassette recorder. I hope you enjoyed the video, and please visit me at the Vintage Tape Recorder Hall of Fame, where I will be appearing along with many of my sibling tape recorders. Bye-bye, YouTube.